The South Australian Premier is calling on the federal government to cut the fuel excise as petrol prices soar across the country. The Prime Minister won't commit to any reduction, but has flagged relief for cost of living pressures in the upcoming budget.
As Russia's war on Ukraine wreaks havoc in Europe, the nation's fuel prices soar to record highs.
The reality is we've got world record prices right now.
Motoring body the RAA says those figures are likely to hit $2.50 within weeks.
If you own two cars, it's the biggest energy bill you have in your house.
Its price hike hurting the transport industry. Uber now rolling out a temporary fuel surcharge on all trips to help reduce financial impact on its drivers. Motorists also feeling the sting at the petrol pump.
It's pretty expensive.
It's absurd. Like, it's been, it's like, it seems like every day it's just getting higher and higher.
The South Australian Premier wrote to Federal Treasurer Josh Frydenberg asking the Commonwealth to reduce its 44.2 cents a litre fuel tax.
This is going to have a massive flow-on effect for cost of living for households, but also for the productivity of the nation. Temporary relief would be very, very much welcomed.
Fuel prices increasing, the tax increases off the back of it. So that penalises people right across our state, right across the country.
But while the Prime Minister won't agree to reduce the excise, he has flagged it could be a part of measures announced in the upcoming budget to help ease the cost of living.
The answer is the budget's at the end of this month.
Stephen Marshall today pledged to make the real-time fuel pricing scheme permanent in South Australia, helping motorists find the cheapest fuel.
By giving them the information to shop around, they've been able to keep money in their back pocket rather than spending it at the petrol bowser.
The state opposition leader also promising to deliver relief to low-income earners.
People on fixed and low incomes are doing it tough and they just don't have the ability to pay for the groceries and put fuel in the car.
Katrina Musson for 10 News First.